Paris.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Outsiders aren't allowed. Why are you here?
Are you threatening me?
I suppose so. This ain't personal. You shouldn't have. Thank you.
missions must be protected. The missions.
Got him!
Missions must be protected.
Confidence on Subject 12 is high. We'll know for certain post-mortem. And any progress on Question 3? None. The EKG shows nothing unexpected. The answers are too damn predictable. You've made your opinion quite clear on the value of Question 3. Removing it could invalidate all the data we've accumulated to date. Moving on, Question 4. The data on this is fascinating. Why does baseball have the highest degree of correlation? Even more than Question 8.
Our methodology was exhaustive. Subject 12's answers in regards to baseball and his childhood were particularly fascinating. See here and here.
I wonder, do they play baseball in the Institute? Or is there some sort of defect in their program?
We need another failure to explore this further. We can do nothing more with Subject 12 except final progress.
I'll let the reclamation team know.
And here you are. My life's work on the verge of ruin, all because of your efforts to find Stockton's supposed daughter. You do know she's most likely a synth, yes? If you are more than a hired gun, perhaps we can stop this before it's too late.
Stockton's daughter is a synth?
Why else do you think we attacked her caravan? After testing, we have well over a 70% confidence level of our initial diagnosis. I'd have to perform an autopsy to be sure.
I'll give you a fair hearing.
How considerate. What would you do if your family was destroyed by a synth right in front of you when you were but a child? Would you roll over and accept it? Or would you do something about it?
Believe me, I've been there, but I haven't resorted to torturing innocents.
Casualties are inevitable. It may not look like it, but we're at war. As long as the Institute walks invisibly amongst us, they strike without warning and control us from the shadows. I've dedicated my life to devising a test to detect these hidden synths, to root them out, so they can be extinguished. Isn't that a goal worth fighting for?
You can't seriously want to kill all the synths.
We most certainly do, but we have to find them first. A living synth is indistinguishable from a human by any medical test yet devised. But it turns out, psychology can detect a difference. Enter the SAFE test. The test is in its infancy, but through sacrifice and perseverance, our success rate is improving.
But your methods are barbaric. It's torture.
To improve the SAFE test, intense psychological pressure must be applied to our test subjects. It is distasteful, but necessary. Covenant is many things. A refuge for the broken people left in the wake of the Institute's rampages. A place of safety and healing. But most importantly, it is our one chance to end this age of paranoia. I will make you a deal. If you let me dispose of Stockton's synth and continue our work, I'll match whatever reward you were offered.
Don't kill the girl. Spare her.
Impossible. The odds are too great she's an Institute infiltrator. Even if she is an unfortunate victim in this war, sparing her can compromise everything.
Continue your work, then.
Excellent.
Dr. Chambers.
And here you are. My life's work on the verge of ruin, all...
Uh-huh.
You do know she's most like...
Go on.
What would you do? Would you roll over?
Believe me.
Casualties, as long as the...
Sure.
I've dedicated... Isn't that a goal?
Someone needs to destroy the Institute.
A perfectly rational, a living sin. But it turns out, the test is...
But your methods are bar...
To improve Covenant, but most... I will...
Sorry. That's a deal I won't accept.
Then you'll just have to kill me.
Goodness, I'm free.
Excuse me.
Please don't hurt me.
It's all right. You're safe now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'm Amelia Stockton. I'm not a synth.
How can I be sure?
Please, you have to believe me. I'm a human being just like you. You saved me. Thank you. My father, Old Man Stockton, he will reward you.
If you're here about the missing caravan, the contract's already been picked up.
Hi.
There you are. You're the one that rescued my daughter.
Yes?
I hadn't asked for help from our mutual friends, but I'm glad you were there, nonetheless.
Helping you is becoming a habit.
One I am grateful for. You deserve this for all you've done.
I had hired a mercenary to do the job, but clearly I should have hired you instead, eh?
Thank you.
Load a little heavy there? I'll buy anything you don't need, and sell everything you do.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Everything is sold as is.
Ammo, weapons, and messy death. I got it all.
Cricket.
Come on, come on! Get your guns here. Small booms, big booms, I got them all.
What kind of stuff do you have?
If it can chamber cock and spit out lead, then I sell it. I sell slashers and clobberers, too, for those maniacs that like it up close. But hot death flying faster than the speed of sound? Oh, my knees are getting weak just from thinking about it.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Guns, guns, and more guns. Just for you.
Too many miles on the road. At least the pay is terrible.
So you want that Toronok? 10 caps.
Any chance I can get it for free?
Fine. The market's in the back, bar's in the corner, and the outhouse is over the wall. Bye.
Not now, Chief.
Need a place to stay? Grab it before someone else does.
This some kind of motel?
I prefer the term flop house, but don't tell my pa that. Gets him mad. When caravans pull into town, they need a place to sleep, so we rent out all the beds we can. So did you want one?
Gonna pass.
You won't get a better deal. This is the only flop house in town.
I haven't seen you before. If you need a doctor, let's get you examined.
So, you're a doctor?
Veterinarian, actually. But don't give me that look. Bones get set the same way whether you got two or four of them. So let's talk about you and what kind of help you need.
You're a veterinarian?
I'm an old caravan girl, okay? You learn to take care of the animals, or you don't have a caravan for very long. Then you get ambushed, a couple of friends and family start bleeding out on the floor, and you learn how to patch a few wounds. You learn triage, too. Satisfied? Now let's talk about what you need patched up.
Yeah. See what's wrong with me, doctor.
Tell me your symptoms.
No injuries that I know of.
Glad to hear it. Anything else?
No cuts or bruises or anything.
Well, good. Hope it stays that way. Anything else?
Actually, never mind, Doc.
Fine. Come back later.
Thank you. Attention. Interfering with a law enforcement robot is a felony.
That's it.
Thank you.
Nice.
Thank you. Wretchedness. place to scare me! Get out of the street before any more of them catch wind of you! Look, I'll open the gate, and you get in here quick! I'm gonna let you in the bunker! Don't make me regret this!
Hey there.
Son, did someone drop you on your head as a baby, or did you have to work to get this stupid?
What the hell were those things?
What, you've never seen a Mirelurk before? You must have lived a charmed life up until now. Mirelurks are disgusting creatures that live near the water. Some of them look like walking fishmen, others like big, butt-ugly lobsters. The ones outside, the crabby-looking ones. Those SOBs are hard to kill on account of the armor you saw. Luckily, I've got Reba here to help me crack those crabs wide open. Isn't that right, girl?
Who's Reba? Are you talking about your gun?
She's not just a gun. She's top of the line. Best gun in the Commonwealth. Made her with my own two hands. Oh. Where are my manners? Introductions. Barney Rook, commander of the Salem Volunteer Militia, at your service. I'm also the quartermaster, sergeant-at-arms, and scribes for all official meetings. This here is Reba, but you two already met when she saved your life.
Is it just the two of you? Where's everyone else?
Wasn't always just two of us. Now, I'd love to sit here gabbing all day like a couple of housewives, but we've got some work to do. And by we, I most definitely mean you. Before you showed up, the Mirelurks had been mostly quiet, and those that were a problem were quickly dispatched by my turret defense system. Since things had been quiet lately, I took the turrets offline to conserve ammunition. Obviously, they need to be reactivated. And that's your mission, soldier. I'm going to continue to hold down the home front while you go reactivate the turrets.
Sounds good.
Of course it sounds good. I'm a tactical genius. Smartest man in town, as a matter of fact. The turrets should be easy enough to find. They're up high in strategic locations around town. Just be careful. All your noise probably woke up more crabbies and other Mirelurks. The town could be crawling with them by now.
Ha!
You did it, didn't you? I could hear that sweet, sweet machine gun music all the way down here. You almost caught me and Reba mid-waltz.
Is that it? Will they come back?
They might, but they'll have something to think about if they do. Now, about that reward. Here's a key to my workshop in the bunker. Reba 2 should be sitting on the table in there. I'd say you earned her. Now, if you'll excuse me, I believe today is earmarked for some target practice. The Salem Volunteer Militia never rests.
Perfect. Hell yeah.
I should study my lines. I wonder if I can lose weight.
What have you got to trade today?